Hi everyone, Dr. Katie here. This video is being posted on Tuesday, May 11th, 2021. Today, I'm coming to you from the Circle Drive-In Theater, the location of tonight's commencement ceremony. More on that a little later. This week, Johnson College is reporting no new positive COVID-19 cases within our campus community. Please, when on campus, continue to keep social distancing and wearing your face coverings. Thank you. I want to say welcome back to campus to all the students who start summer classes this week. While registration for summer session 1 is now closed, there's still time to register for summer session 2 that starts on June 28th. Each credit is only $199. Visit johnson.edu/registrar for more details. Later this week, the 12th episode of the Tech Talk with Johnson College podcast will be available on our website, johnson.edu, Spotify, and iTunes. In this episode, I welcome Nick Scarnato, the Executive Vice President of New Vision Industries, a precision manufacturing company located in the southern tier of New York, and a 1980 Johnson College graduate. During our conversation, we discuss Nick's path from Old Forge to Johnson College to Binghamton University and then into the aerospace industry. We also talk about his memories of Johnson College and how he continues to use skills he perfected at the college more than 40 years ago. It's a great conversation, and I hope you enjoy it. Since it's the 12th episode of the podcast and the last for this academic year, I want to say thank you to all of our guests, Kelly Barrett from Rhodes Scholar, Terry Ohms from the Institute for Public Policy and Economic Development, Johnson College's Computer Information Technology instructor and alum, Matt Serba, Steve Madura from Johnson Controls, Daryl Jane from Gibbons Ford, Latita Smith from the Moses Taylor Foundation, Ryan Leckie from WNEP, Glynis Johns from the Black Scranton Project, Jim Wanzak from SLHDA, Michelle Bannon from the City of Carbondale, and of course, Nick Scarnato from New Visions. Thank you for so many great conversations this year. Again, you can listen to all the Tech Talk with Johnson College podcast episodes on iTunes, Spotify, and our website, johnson.edu. As you schedule your summer plans, remember the Andrew Mazza Diesel Jam will be held Saturday, July 10th, here at the Circle Drive-In Theater. Diesel Jam 2021 supports the Andrew Mazza Foundation, our diesel truck technology program, and high school students through scholarship opportunities. Visit andrewmazzafoundation.com/dieseljam for more information. Last Tuesday night, before the storms came through the valley, we held our 2021 awards night outside on campus. It was so nice to see our soon-to-be graduates along with their families celebrating their hard work and academic accomplishments. Congratulations to all our graduates who received awards and to our committee who created a night to remember while continuing to adhere to all social distancing and face covering guidelines. Speaking of graduates, tonight, May 11th, is the big night. At dusk, our 2021 commencement ceremony will take place here at the Circle Drive-In Theater. If you cannot attend, you can still watch the entire ceremony via a live stream available on our website, johnson.edu. Thank you to the Circle Drive-In Theater management and staff for hosting our commencement ceremony for the second year in a row. It's going to be a great night for all of our graduates, their families, and our entire Johnson College community. And now for my final note of the week. I really cannot believe that it's May and we're at the end of the spring 2021 semester. First and foremost, I want to say what a year it has been, but we did it, Johnson College. Once again, we took what others saw as insurmountable circumstances and utilized all of our strengths to come out the other side stronger than ever before. This year brought the pandemic, 2 accreditations once again, an extremely positive virtual site visit from the Middle States Site Evaluation Team, new and engaging fundraising events, more grants awarded than ever before, the strongest enrollment in our history, the best registration numbers that I believe we have ever seen going into a fall, the demolition of Richmond Hall, the design of a new gateway building for campus in the greater Scranton community, and a strategic planning process that was inclusive and engaging. We have received outstanding press coverage and exposure to the public through new venues and in new ways. And through all of this, we kept providing the best Johnson College experience for our students. We kept them safe and we remained open, and I know they are grateful for that. thank you faculty, staff, board members, industry partners, alumni, and students for another outstanding year. At a time when we all could have used the pandemic as an excuse to sit back and take it easy, we did the opposite. We stepped on the gas and we said, let's go. While there will always be work to do, improvements to be made, and new efforts to try, please take some time to reflect on all that we have accomplished together and all that you have accomplished as an individual. Be proud, Johnson College, because let me tell you, if a pandemic didn't stop us, nothing will. And something tells me we're just getting started. That's it for this week's presidential update video from the Circle Drive-In Theater, the home of our 2021 commencement ceremony. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, be well, and have a great week.